Today's analysis is all about cattle. Last week, cattle futures ended on a record high. One analyst sees that momentum continuing into 2014. We're here now with Joe Vaklavic. Joe, let's talk cattle. And there's some pretty positive news when we think about Friday and what happened Friday. Cash cattle prices, futures, you know, go into that and what we saw happen.
Well, you saw sharply higher prices across the board, whether it was cash or futures or even some of the back months futures markets tested some of their highs that they put in a couple of months ago. Things are kind of cyclical in the commodity markets, and the grain producer had their day here for many years, and the cattle producer was operating at a loss. And maybe finally now we're going to get the cattle feeder back to profitability. I don't know if we're there quite yet or where they'd like to be, but you know, looking at some of these charts, if you were to break out these fat cattle contracts above some of these highs from a couple months ago, things could start to look real friendly, real fast. We saw packers really bidding up for cattle here last week, and I think the outlook is pretty positive moving forward here.
Why are we really seeing this up move? Is it still from the drought? Is it a different situation? Is it because of lower feed costs? What's going on right now?
I think you've still got some lingering effects of the drought. I think that that's a big part of the reason why numbers are as low as they are. You've got demand for beef at a wholesale and retail level that's backed off significantly because of high prices. So it all kind of feeds on itself here more than anything. But you know, the cattle feeder in the U.S. should love this cheap corn. It kind of looks like things might be turning a corner there. And I know that there's still a lot of pessimism there. I don't know necessarily that the average cattle producer is real optimistic right now, especially when you're looking at nearly record high prices, things that, you know, in the long-term view might not be sustainable. But I'm kind of optimistic here that maybe you see some more upside.
Okay, let's go into that a little bit more. We saw the upside right before we ended 2013, going into 2014. How long do you see that lasting?
It's tough to say. You know, if this were to really become one of these parabolic explosive type markets where you break out above the highs, I don't think you could rule out a 140 fat cattle price on the board. I don't think you can rule out a 136 or 137 cash trade at some point in time. I'm kind of optimistic here to start off the year for a number of reasons, mostly just because I'm seeing how tight this thing is. I'm seeing the Packers bid up, and it seems like there's just no stopping it for the moment anyways.
All right. Good news for cattle then. Thank you so much, Joe. We appreciate it. Please stay with us. We'll be back with more Ag Day in just a moment.
For more information about Standard Grain and its services, call Joe at 312-462-4438. Ag Day, brought to you by Ag Explore. Nurse your soil back to health with the right prescription of Endzone and Prevent.